The time period chivalry set in is roughly the most iconic period in the medieval era between the Crusader era and the transition towards the plate armor. So basically we want to capture those two images. And so we picked a fictional realm, a fictional setting, but referencing most of those historical version of the knight. And to do so, it doesn't limit our choices in what we can include in the video game. The key artistic element of art for that time would be mostly what people envision knight or warriors in that time is encased in mail or chainmail or plate armor and leather. So those are the variety of armor sets we create in the game. And the weapons are basically what people love to see, broadsword, claymore, you know, axes, spear. So basically we looked at all the variety of visual weapon range, and we select the most iconic ones and what people recognize the most, and we represent them in a game. Yeah, the reason we went with a Hollywood realism style of art, for the art direction in Chivalry is because we find that what captivate the gamers from you know, like a medieval era is what we see in movies and books and you know, illustrations that we see in those medieval eras. So we try to mimic or capture that feeling in our game. So all our images are a little bit grand and exaggerated in a way, but it's not too far away from realism. So when you look at it, you can still see functionality in the armor, the weapons. They're pretty closely resembling the historical referencing, but not heavily limit on it. I guess the favorite character for me to work on in Chivalry would have to be the knight class characters, because their armor is the most, you know, interesting to draw, and they have a lot of elements like the shoulder pads, the helmet, and I just find I was always passionate about knights in medieval eras.